So the first time I recorded today's episodes, I didn't wear a microphone, which made the sound less good. Yeah. Whoops. Liz Cheney didn't come right out and say she expects to lose her primary next month. But in an interview with CNN's Jake Tapper on Sunday, it was pretty easy to read between the lines of the Wyoming Republicans' answers.
I am working hard here in Wyoming to earn every vote. But I will also say this, I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to say things that aren't true about the election. My opponents are doing that, certainly simply for the purpose of getting elected.
And at another point, she said this.
If I have to choose between maintaining a seat in the House of Representatives or protecting the Constitutional Republic and ensuring the American people know the truth about Donald Trump, I'm going to choose the Constitution and the truth every single day.
Now, pressed by Tapper whether her service as vice chair of the House's January 6th Select Committee will have been worth it even if she loses next month, Cheney responded,
I believe that my work on this committee is the single most important thing I've ever done professionally.
Now, if all that sounds to you like Cheney is framing the August 16th primary as a sort of fait accompli, and as not the end of a story, but as part of a broader narrative, well, then you, sir or ma'am, are correct. The simple fact is that Cheney is very unlikely to beat Harriet Hageman in next month's Wyoming primary. Hageman has the support of, among others, former President Donald Trump, as well as a number of top Republican leaders, including House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy. Cheney, on the other hand, is detested by Republicans who swear fealty to Trump. And in Wyoming, that's a majority of Republicans. While Cheney has reportedly been trying to recruit Democrats to cross party lines and support her, and some undoubtedly will, it's very hard to see that making a real difference in the outcome of this race. Simply put, Cheney looks likely to lose, and lose big, and she knows it. Sidebar, crazy things happen, polls can be wrong, it ain't over till it's over, and all that. But to be clear, all signs suggest Cheney is headed for a primary loss. What Cheney also knows is that, at least in her mind, this isn't the end of her political story. Here's how Cheney answered a question from Tapper on whether she's interested in running for president in 2024. Watch.
I haven't really, at this point, I have not made a decision about 2024. But I do think as we look towards the next presidential election, as I said, you know, I believe that our nation stands on the edge of an abyss. And I do believe that we all have to really think very seriously about the dangers we face and the threats we face. And we have to elect serious candidates.
That pretty much tells you everything you need to know about Liz Cheney in 2024. She isn't an announced candidate yet. But when you hear a politician talking about the country standing on the edge of an abyss and the need to elect serious candidates, well, it doesn't take an astrophysicist, thankfully, to figure out what's really going on here. The real question at this point seems to be then not whether Cheney runs, she sounds to all the world like that decision is at least mostly made, but rather whether she can have any sort of actual impact in the 2024 race. If Cheney runs as a Republican, it will undoubtedly be a very tough road for her. Trump is the clear frontrunner in most polling conducted on the 2024 presidential primary and seems very likely to run again. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis is seen as the only serious alternative to Trump, at least at the moment, and he's positioned himself as an advocate of Trumpism, just without Trump. There's no candidate garnering any serious support in hypothetical 2024 polls who's running expressly against Trump and the actions he took and didn't take during his 4 years in office. The people, aside from Cheney, who are signaling an interest in running that sort of campaign, term-limited Maryland Governor Larry Hogan is probably the most high-profile example other than Cheney, they barely register in polls on the race. Could Cheney somehow coalesce the anti-Trump vote within the Republican Party? Sure, possible. But even if she was to do so, there's scant evidence that that block of voters comprise anything close to a majority of likely Republican primary voters. The other and more plausible, I think, path for Cheney is to run as an independent in the 2024 presidential race. Assuming Trump is the Republican nominee, which is a safe assumption, such a candidacy could skim off enough votes in swing states and nationally to potentially hamstring the former president's chances of winning. Presumably Cheney, who is a conservative on most issues other than Donald Trump, would appeal more to Republicans than Democrats in a general election. But even under that scenario, Cheney would function as a spoiler, trying to keep Trump from the White House rather than as a viable candidate to be elected president herself, which, given what she told Tapper Sunday, might be enough for her.
I'm fighting hard No matter what happens on August 16th, I'm going to wake up on August 17th and continue to fight hard to ensure Donald Trump is never anywhere close to the Oval Office ever again.
And that is The Point. We make new Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.